check up here. I haven't checked up here yet. I don't even know, like, what I'm looking for here. Is it like a regular sized mouse? Are you a mouse, kid? Kid, are you a mouse? Oh! Wait. Oh, look at you! I saw the little spot on my map, and I don't remember that being there before. Eek! Leave me alone! What? Oi, you little pipsqueak, you're the one who tried to make a quick gilder selling the holy wood, aren't you? Squeak! How'd you find me? I'll never do it again, honest, never, ever, or my name's not Pip. Pip? But why? What made you start stealing? I needed the money, didn't I? Not that it's any of your blinking business. How am I going to make my dreams come true if I'm broke? He looks like Harry Potter. Your dreams? That's no excuse for stealing. What kind of dreams do you have, anyway? Nice try, dum-dum. You think I'm telling you? I know you'll just laugh at me for being silly little mouse with big ideas. Crikey, bit bloomin' touchy, aren't we? There's no need to be so flippin' defensive, mouse face. Well, we did just corner him, to be fair. Anyway, let's collar the little runt and head back to the Cottermaster store, shall we? Wait a second, you guys. Is it just me, or does Pip really remind you of somebody? You mean he might share a soul with someone back in Motorville? I think so, but I'm just not sure who it could be. Pip. Would you mind telling us a little more about your dream? We won't laugh at you, I promise. Why should I? You can't tell me what to do. Why should I take orders from a big baby who sleeps with a stupid doll? Wait, how does he know that? What? Is that true, Oliver? No, I don't sleep with a doll anymore. Haha, how grown up of you. But I bet you still drag it around with you everywhere in case you get scared at night, you big baby. I do not. I told you, I don't sleep with a doll anymore. I stopped taking Mr. Drippy to bed almost a year ago. Oh. Ha ha ha. Now you've done it, dum-dum. You all heard him, didn't you? I bet your girlfriend's really impressed now. Stop being mean. She's not my... And I don't sleep with a doll. Cut it out, will you? Just cut it out, Phil. Eh? Did you just call him Phil? That mangy mouse's name is Pip. I'm sorry, it's just what he said. It sounded just like Phil when he's being mean. Blimey. Well, you know what that means. I don't know what you're on about. All I know is you'll never catch me. This rotten rodent is starting to get on my nerves. He's not making things easy for us, is he? What are we going to do, Oliver? Well, it took me a while to work it out, but there's no mistake. He can be kind of mean and real stubborn, but he's still my best friend. I'm talking about Phil. Tidy, I think we've got our man. Just goes to show, if you've got a big bully for a soulmate, you might just turn out to be a nasty piece of work, too. I get it. Something must be going on with his soulmate to have made this mouse turn into a life of crime. I feel kind of bad. It's been a while since I saw Phil. I hope he's okay. Let's go and see Philip in Motorville. Come on, Oliver. There's no time to waste. Alright, I guess we're going to Motorville. And we can also finish that quest about the girl wanting the flower and stuff in Motorville. Cast Gateway. Off to Motorville we go. It's been a while. I hope everybody still recognizes me. Ah, okay. Hey, car. I really want to test if Drippy could get hit by a car. Or, I mean, I know he can't. But the cars can see him because they stop for him. So, what's up with that, game? What's over here? Is this Phil? This is a little girl who has dead flowers. Okay, what? Let's go and find Philly boy, shall we? What, I can't talk to her? There we go. That she is, my lad. Her and that little missy over at Perdita could be twins, man. Soulmates, they are my donkey's dad. Huh? What do you want? I have something to ask you. The flowers you grow, do you have any pink ones? Sure, I have pink tulips. They're real pretty. You do? Do you think you might let me have some? I would, but they're all dried up. Huh? Dried up? Yep, look. Boy, they're kind of shriveled, huh? Mr. Drippy, is there anything we can do? What are you asking me for? You're the flippin' wizard, ain't you? How am I supposed to know if you've got a spell that'll restore flowers to their former flippin' glory? Of course, I can use magic to bring them back. Rejuvenate. Nothing happens. Why not? Am I not facing the flowers, maybe? Aha! Here we go. Look at that! They're blooming. There's beautiful. Nice one, Ollie boy. So now will she give me the flowers? Neato, the flowers came right back to life. Wow, you're amazing. That was like magic, she says. The cheek of it. That was magic, love. The real deal. Huh? Did you hear something? I thought I heard somebody yelling. No way, Munch. You can hear me. How do, love? Nice weather we've been having, isn't it? Mr. Drippy, not now. Hey, did you just hear a voice down near the ground there? No. Guess it must have been the wind. Anyway, about those flowers, can I maybe have some? Sure, but you have to promise to show me another magic trick next time. Trick? They're not tricks, Mun. They're spells. Spells, you cheeky little... Got it. Hometown flower. Nailed it. All right, now we're going to here. Speak to our buddy Phil. Ooh, maybe we might face a nightmare. Saving time. Okay, so I know for sure. I mean, his eyes were purple. Phil's eyes. So I know we're gonna end up facing a nightmare. So I went out and leveled a little bit, not too much. I also went over pretty much every single one of my character's weapons and armor. And I improved them as much as I could. I bought a couple things, which is not... I mean, I had this Aurora Cloak made, I think. I think I made this Aurora Cloak for this guy. Why am I keeping this guy around, you ask? Well, because he's got a very interesting spell here. Enlighten. Opens the mind of the user, boosting magical attack. So I'm going to try to use that on Oliver before or during the fight against the nightmare that I'm about to face from Purple-Eyed Phil. And see how much that does. I also fed a few familiars. Yeah, that's pretty much it. I'm considering getting rid of the fairy now because it really serves no purpose. All I need is Ullabaloo. That's all I need. I gave him stout armor, steel scales. This guy takes one attack damage or one hit point damage from pretty much anybody. Even boss fights, probably. I don't know. I also have a bunch of stamp cards because I've been doing a few bounties, a couple, obviously. Look at that. I get 6 for that. Poisoner's Horn. I already have one of those. I don't even think I'm using it. If I get like another 6 and pure steel armor. I already have one of those and I'm not using it. 1500 guilders. Now I get another stamp, which means a bonus. Sweet. Which means I think I have 2. Yeah, I have 6. So I can claim 2 options. Helps you strike fear into your enemies, causing them to drop more items. Allows you to collect any glims that remain at the end of a battle automatically. Lowers the cost of continuing your game. I'm not worried about that one. I'm going to go with these 2. And this one. Yeah. That's a good one to have if you're leveling and stuff. Or just in a dungeon. So that's good. Okay, good. We're ready. Let's go travel back to our buddy, Phil. Now I'm ready to face his nightmare. Whoa, what am I doing? Gateway. I can't cast it. Oh, I can cast it in here. Wow, I didn't even realize you can cast it indoors. Right in front of this guy.
What is going on? That kid, he's got some blue light around him. I don't know what's happening.
He's got a bird hat, so I imagine he talks like that. Let's get down to Philly boy. There should be a yellow car that almost hits me right here. Let me just... right there. I was trying to prove that he could see Drippy. Look at Drippy. Look at him running after me. What a derp face. Oh man, I'm a little bit scared of dealing with this guy. Okay. Ooh, maybe I should save one last time. Nah, it's okay. We saved just before. All I'll have to do is buy those things over again. Oh, it's you. Come to get even, huh? Even? Even for what? All I wanted was to build an auto all of my own. A hot rod faster and finer than any other. Sure you did, Phil. It was what we both wanted. But my dream, it killed somebody. It kills your mom. Wow. Don't say that, Phil. Don't ever say that. It wasn't your fault. I don't want to worry you, Ollie boy, but there's a funny look in your mate's eyes. Yeah, they're purpley. I knew it. Saw that coming a mile away. All right. Let's deal with Phil's nightmare. So let's start off. How should we start off? Philip's nightmare, void of ambition. This guy needs some ambition, man. Come on. Wow, that's like the slowest intro to a fight. Alright, we're gonna start with Swain. We're gonna start with this guy. We're gonna go all out attack. We're gonna enlighten. Oh, he boosts his own attack. That's not good. Okay, well, we're gonna go with Oliver now. Oh, defend. Ill will, what's this? What the heck was that? Oh, that's a... Okay, that must have been Unleash. Oh yeah, we wanna try these too, but first we're gonna go with Arrow of Light. We're only gonna try those when he's stunned or something. Ooh, that hurt. Everybody attack, let's go, guys. No, not Unleash, not Fortune's Fool, what is this? A sinister voice rings out. To my own dudes? Is that what happened there? Arrow of Light. Aha, suck it. Everybody defend. Reign of Terror, okay. So Ill Will is a stat booster. Reign of Terror is an offensive attack. Ogle's gonna, yeah, he's gonna avoid it. Nice job, but oh, I'm confused. No. What are you doing? Oliver, holy crap, it caused so much damage to me. .143, that's good. Good. Reign of Terror, here it comes again. What the heck? I blocked. I'm poisoned now. Great. Touch me. Everybody go. And I really want him to be knocked out here soon. Oh, we don't have to, but let's do it just in case I missed something the first time. No, I think he's okay. I'm not worried about the poison. It only does 9 damage. It's not worth it to even worry about it. I have plenty of coffees. I think if I just take my time, this guy will be down in a second. Or, not a second. If I take my time, he'll be down in a few minutes. Oh, wow, he did a lot of damage. Heal me. Thank you. Is everybody attacking or what? Everybody should be attacking. Ooh, I am out of... Defend. Reign of Terror, here it comes again. Oh, get out! Ow! What the heck? Okay, provisions. 100 HP to all... No, that's not important. 70 magic points to me. Let's get these. Ill Will. That doesn't matter. Let him do what he wants. Arrow of Light. Yeah! You know what? It's time to try one of these bad boys. Hopefully they do a lot of damage. And they're probably going to cost a lot, though. Unleash. Let's see. Storm damage. Physical damage. Damage to all enemies. Fire damage. Storm damage. Water damage. Let's go with Everblade, because it deals physical damage to a single enemy, and it's only 21 points. Oh, that is pretty cool. 204. Okay. What? It's time for our boy to enter into action. What's 11 damage? You suck, buddy. That does more damage than the ray of light. How about the heat ray? 110. Okay. I need more. I already need more coffee. Everybody defend. Oh, he's Ill Will. No, provisions. This guy doesn't seem to be too tough. Where's my espresso? 150? Nah. We just need a cappuccino. She's still okay for magic, so let's just keep going here. She's still full. Swain's still full. This is going pretty good. Yeah, we're fine. The Arrow of Light seems like a good bang for the buck in terms of magic points for damage. Reign of Terror, here it comes. That is one big dude. Phil's a small guy, but his nightmare is enormous. We got poison or something? Don't touch me. Arrow of Light in your face. Everybody attack. splish splash, he was taking a bath. This guy, yeah, he's done. He's done. Get out of here, buddy. Get out of here. That hurts, though, when he slaps you like that. Ill will. That's not important. Let's try pulse on him. No, let's finish him off. Ooh, let's finish him off with one of these attacks. Windfall. Yeah, sure, we saw Everblade. Let's see Windfall. And she healed me. Thank you very much, Esther. Oh, there he is, the very first boss. That's awesome. 141, that's pretty cool. Everybody still attacking? I need more coffee. No, I don't. Do it, Ullabaloo. Comes Reign of Terror. One last hurrah for this guy. Look at Ullabaloo's face. He doesn't... He's like the honey badger. Oh, he's missing a lot. I wanted to finish him off with a physical attack. Yes! Suck it, Phil's nightmare.
Is that it?
That's it. Lots of levels. Ooh. Esther didn't level. She's like the only one. Oh, and Mighty didn't level. Man. 44, 38, 22. 32, 35. It's amazing that Ullabaloo's still at 22. I've used him so much. He's my MVP for sure. Just get in there, take a pounding right in his face. Phil! Gah, all of it. It's all my fault. Flippin' heck, the poor lad's still brokenhearted. Phil! You must really hate me, Ollie. I guess we're not friends anymore, huh? No, I never said that. It should have been me. It should have been... me in that car. It should have been me in the river. Oh man, that's that way your mom would have never had to save you. That way she'd still be alive. You can't think like that, Phil. It won't change anything. What was I thinking trying to build a car? If I hadn't built that hunk of junk, none of this would have ever happened. It was a pretty cool car, man. Phil, this isn't what my mom would have wanted. She wouldn't want to see you like this. We were trying to make our dreams come true. We were trying to make the neatest car in the whole world, remember? Our dreams? Uh-oh, still got the purple eyes. Gah, who cares? Wow! Just socked him right in the face! But, didn't you listen to a word I said? Your mom's dead because of our dumb dreams. So what do I do now? Build another car? Mess it up again? Get somebody else? Get them? I can't. I just punched Oliver in the face. Listen to me, Phil. My mom would never want us to give up on our dreams. I just know it. You remember all those times we'd sneak into the car factory? Remember the old guy we made friends with there, the engineer? He told us all about cars, didn't he? And we promised him we'd make a car better than anything Motorville had ever seen. Sure, my mom used to tell us we had cars on the brain, but when she heard us talk about our dream, she'd smile. She never really got mad at us, did she? I remember. She wanted us to follow our dreams. I know she did. Follow our dreams. I know it's what my mom would have wanted. You can't give up on your dreams. Huh? Well, I never. I didn't see this one coming, Ollie boy. It's your own heart that's making the locket glow. Your heart's brimming with ambition. I should have known. But what am I supposed to do? Can I really take a piece of my own heart? Well, it can't hurt to try now, can it? And it'll make a change from borrowing from other folks. Go on, Mun, give it a go. Okay, here goes. Take heart on myself. Now I've got ambition. Amazing. Jeepers, creepers, that sure felt strange. I guess that must be how all the people who helped us felt, huh? Nice one, Ollie boy. I told you it was worth a try, didn't I? Hold on, Phil. There's something I need to share with you. Give him some heart. Give him the ambition you got off yourself before he drives me potty, will you? Yes, I'll fix him with a piece of my own heart. Give heart. Ambition. Now is he back to his normal-eyed self? Huh? What did you... What is this? I feel kinda warm inside. There it is. There's those regular eyeballs. I don't know what's wrong with me, Ollie. I just can't stop crying. But I feel all warm and fuzzy, too. You know what that is, Phil? That's my mom trying to tell you something. She's telling you to never give up on your dreams. Never give up? That's right. And we don't want to let my mom down, do we? So that means we have to keep on going. Keep on chasing after our dreams. I can't let my mom down. I won't! You're right, Ollie. I won't give up. I won't give up on my dreams. On our dreams. And that's a promise, Ollie. Phil! Oh. Aww.
Ollie. Phil.
Friends. I'm going to study hard and go to college, then I'm going to build a car that's safe, a car people can rely on. You see if I don't. You'll hold me to that, won't you, Ollie? Sure I will, Phil. Now there's one other thing I gotta tell you, Ollie. If you're gonna keep dressing like a weirdo, I can't be seen with you. Oh, these clothes, it's not what you think. Nah, it's okay, really. If you want to dress like a crazy, who am I to stop you? Nah, I got important things to do. See you around, kiddo. Dressing like a weirdo. To tell you the truth, Ollie boy, I didn't know if nabbing a nugget of your own heart was gonna work. Well, it looks like it worked fine, Mr. Drippy. Phil's back to his old self. I've been waiting for ages. Where is he? Huh? Who said that? Oh, it's P. P. Oh. Huh? A? What's wrong with him all of a sudden? Oliver, I've been waiting. Where were you? P, what are you doing here? This is my house. P, you mean P's here right now? Yes, she came right out of my house. But how did you get inside? Easy peasy. I can open any door I like. Listen, P, I'm not sure I understand. Who were you waiting for? You silly. I've got something to tell you. Oliver, are you sure you'll be all right? Whatever happens? Even if you find out the truth? The truth? I'm worried about you, Oliver. Are you sure you'll be all right? Well, I'm not exactly sure what it is you're worried about, P, but as long as my friends are with me, I'll be fine. You don't have to worry about me. Good. Oh, Oliver. What is it? I'll always watch over you. Okay? Thanks. So what did P have to say, Oliver? We only heard what you said. She said she was worried about me, so I told her that I had my friends with me and that I was going to be okay. Of course you are, Ollie boy. You've got the Lord High Lord of the Fairies on your side, isn't it? And don't forget me. We've been through a fair few scrapes. But we're still going strong, aren't we? Ha, as if he'd forget you, Swain. Thanks, you guys. That means a lot. Now Phil's back to his old self. So let's go see Pip. Right. Back we go to Ding Dong Dale. Cool. Let us open the gates to another alternate dimension. I have that rose I should give back to that girl in that place. Oh, it brings me back here, huh? Okay. Let's travel to Ding Dong Dale. This fast traveling is very convenient. If I had to walk there or boat there or even fly there on Tengri, it would take forever. Alright, so where are we going to find this little mouse? This Pip. Pip squeak. I wonder if we could find him in the same spot. Let's go check that same spot first. Ooh, 5 guilders. I will gladly take free money. Is he up here? He sure is. Hey man, we're back. And now, you have to give us that log. Eek, it's you. Look, I'm really sorry. That thing I stole, it was really important, wasn't it? Huh? What a flippin' transformation, man. Looks like this mouse really is your pal's soulmate. The thing is, I've already sold it. I sell things to the local shopkeepers, you see. I just don't know what to do. Don't worry, Pip. Let's just explain to the shopkeeper what happened. I'm sure he'll understand. I'm so sorry, Oliver. Okay, so now we gotta talk to the shopkeep. Ah, you're back, I see. And we've caught ourselves a thief. Come on, Pip Squeak, out with it. This piece of wood, it was me. I stole it. You stole it? A little chap like you? He confessed, didn't he? That mouse stole it and sold it to you, the rotter. He confessed, didn't he? Yeah, okay, got it. I haven't spent any of the money, I promise. I'll give it all back to you. Well, I sense this is an item of some value to you, and that its loss has caused you some distress. I hate to see it go, but I know where it belongs. What a nice guy. Well, that's sorted then. We're lucky the shopkeeper wasn't in the mood to rook us. You know, Pip, I can't believe you turned yourself in and returned the money. And you call yourself a thief? I'm no thief. I'm telling you, it was just a moment of madness. I'm so, so sorry. I'll do anything to make it up to you. I mean it. Listen, it's okay. We got it back in the end. Oh, I almost forgot. You said that your dreams had driven you to become a thief. That's right. I've got big dreams, and they don't come cheap. I need guilders and lots of them. Have you ever heard of something called a cloud sweeper? Isn't that a sort of flying broom powered by magic? Not my kind of thing. Well, it's my kind of thing, that's for sure. Ever since I was little, I've always wanted to build my very own cloud sweeper. I wanted to build the fastest, bestest cloud sweeper in the whole world. Is it just me, or does he really remind you of someone? He sure does. Say, Pip, building something that goes real fast is super neat, huh? Ha, finally someone who understands me. Thanks for taking the time to hear me talk about my dreams. Now I need to save up some money, the honest way. Good luck, Pip. This guy wants to build a cloud sweeper. Sounds awesome. I'm gonna sweep clouds right up. Sweepity, sweep the clouds. Alright, can we go see the Rat King or whatever his name is? King Tom, that's it. He's a cat, not a rat. Can I go that way? No. Alright, off we go then. To see King Tom. So what do you guys think? Was I a little overpowered? I don't even know why I'm asking you. Honestly, I've stopped reading all the comments, and it sucks. I hate to do it. I really want to read the comments, because you guys always give me good tips and stuff, but I can't, because some people feel the need to spoil the game for me. So I really don't want the game spoiled for me, so I've stopped reading the comments altogether, and that's a sad, sad thing. Very sad. I really wish I could, but you guys, some of you, very few of you, like to spoil things. I'm not sure why that is. Why you get your jollies? That's weird. It looked like he turned around when I hit the map. Oh, you know what? Esther's not healed up. I hope I don't have to fight anything right now. In fact, yeah, let's save real quick. Alright, here we go. King Tom, we're here. Give us wood. That's so... Oh, I'm such a dirty-minded bastard. It's good to see you again, Mr. Meowjesty. Ah, you have returned. How the devil have you been? One has been busying oneself with that rogue hickory de... Mwah.
Mwah.
Unless one is very much mistaken, you come bearing the holy wood of Alma Moon. That's right, we wanted to ask a favor of you, your Meowjesty. No need to continue, dear girl. One knows precisely why you are here, so the Caliphah chose to entrust the holy wood to you. It seems the time has come to reunite the power of the three kingdoms. Now, dear boy, allow one to do one's royal duty. That's gross, dude. Whoa. Whoa! Did he just carve that? Wow, you obtained a piece of carved holy wood. Wow, that was amazing. Meow? Well, surely you expected nothing less. Thank you, your Meowjesty. It sure has been great seeing you, but we have to head to Hamelin now. So Markison's up next. Here's hoping he's been practicing his carpentry. Why are you mumbling to yourself, Swain? So you're off to Hamelin, huh? Or, Take care, won't you? It's a rather grubby place for one so very pure. I've been there before, man. It's no big deal. Hop, 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 hop. Okay. To Hamelin we shall go. Do 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 do. I doubt I'm near the end of the game. I was checking out some stats, and I don't think I always get this shard. Dark shard or whatever it's called. I forgot what it's called. Shadow glass, that's it. Look, check this out. Was it here, or was it here? Progress report, there it is. So look, Wizard's Companion completion only 66%, Creature Compendium completion only 40%, so I've only seen 40% of the creatures possible. Task completion, 45%. That means I'm like halfway through the game? Alchemy only 11%. Hidden treasures found 73 of 100. That's pretty good, though. I don't think I'm near the end. I don't think. We'll see. We'll see what happens. Let's go talk to Markison. He'll set us straight. That guy's still looking for creatures. Ooh, there's a few side quests I can do here. Not gonna bother with them now. Honestly, I was gonna do all the side quests and stuff on camera, but they... Oh, dude, you are taking up a lot of space. They're all, like 90% of them, I won't say all of them, 90% of them are me taking heart from somebody and giving heart to somebody else. The side quests, I'm a little disappointed in the side quests. Then you got the bounty hunts, which are pretty simple. I haven't found one bounty hunt yet that actually gives me a hard time. Oh, I could have taken that stupid ring straight to Markison's place, couldn't I? I sure could. It's okay. We'll take the scenic route. Enjoy the scenery. See, that ring would have taken me right here. More walking. These shoes were made for jumping. Off we go to see Markison. Another big dude guy. Your buddy. I saw your buddy. He was taking up the whole sidewalk. Your buddy's so fat. How fat is he? Takes up the whole sidewalk. That was the worst joke ever. Yeah, we're going straight. You gotta figure there's gonna be a twist here somehow. We're gonna have to do something first before Markison actually does what he's supposed to do. Whatever it is he's gonna do. Here we go. Okay. Let's remember that thing's there. Can we get some voice acting this time? Let's get some voice up in here. Ah, dang it. Hello, Markison. We need you to finish carving something for us. Flippin' heck, someone didn't go to finishing school. Heard of the word please, have you? Ha, I do enjoy your visits. There is a certain liveliness you bring to every occasion. Now, you mentioned carving something? Yes, your majesty. Esther was talking about the Clarion. That's right. We need you to help us finish it so we can clear a path across the miasma marshes. I see. Well, you have come to the right place. The Clarion may only be completed by the ruler of Hamelin. But I am afraid there is a minor problem. Of course there is. Namely, that he does not possess all of the skills required. Huh? How do you mean, your majesty? To complete the Clarion, one must possess not only magical power, but the talent to carve the necessary holes. While I may have the magical skills, I am unable to help with the more practical aspects of the process. So you're saying you're too clumsy to complete the Clarion? It's not a matter of clumsiness, I assure you. No, the skills that are required are passed from the Emperor directly to his heir. Gee, so your father passed away before he could teach you about this stuff, huh? Well then, we'll just have to go back in time and get him to teach you. Blinkin' heck, you make it sound so flippin' easy. You only get to use breach time once in a lifetime, remember? Ah, you're right. Well then, what do we do? Aren't you forgetting someone? Swain? Do you mean... truly? Did he? Well, I can't promise miracles, but Father did teach me a few things, yeah. Oh. Well, there you go. Ah, yes, your father. Did he, come from this kingdom too? Only you never mentioned... Gah, alright. I just didn't want to make a big deal out of it. Yes, Markison's my brother and my real name's Gascon. There, I've said it. Oh, that? We knew that already. Yeah, we were there, you know. Then why are you so hell-bent on getting me to admit it? Anyway, we can discuss the whys and wherefores later on. The point is, my father's taught me what I need to know. And you're telling us this now? If you'd let us know a bit earlier, we wouldn't have had to come all the way to Hamelin, would we? I'm afraid it's not that simple. Of course not. I can't do the magic part, you see. Flippin' heck, so you're no use to us either, is it? That is not quite true. Ah, so you know what I'm getting at, do you? I suppose it's not all bad having a brain box of a great sage for a brother. I'm not sure I understand. What cannot be done alone may yet be done together. Is that not so, brother? Oh, I get it. You're gonna make it together. Exactly. Now give it here. Here we go. Can we have some voice after this? No. Are you ready, Markison? We've got work to do. Yes, brother, I am ready. Hey, we got some voice.
Wow. That thing sure seems powerful.
Yes, and they work so well together.
Wow.
You obtained the Clarion. Now we can finally clear a path to Shadar's castle. Thank you, Your Majesty, and thank you too, Swain. Oh, don't worry about thanking me, but how long is it since we last made something together, Markuson? Ha! Do you remember the model pig tank we made together? Blurg. A bloomin' pig tank? That's the last pigging thing I want to be reminded of. Heh, you'll hear no arguments from me on that score. Anyway, let's focus on the task ahead, clearing the miasma marshes. The Clarion looks so beautiful. I can't wait to hear how it sounds. I think you should be the one to play it, Esther. Yeah, Ollie Boy's right. If you ask me, there ain't no better woman for the job. I agree. I mean, I'd love to do it, but I'm tone deaf. I'll do it. I'll play the Clarion and clear a path through the miasma marshes. I truly believe you will, Esther. Thank you, Your Majesty. Come on, Oliver, we should get going. You're right. It's time to head to the miasma marshes. Alright. The unbreakable bond between the hearts of two princes and the last story was his companion. The Flute Makers. Aha! I saw you. I remembered you. Yes, go to the palace entrance. Oh. Okay, yeah, I take you to the palace entrance. Yeah, that makes sense. For some reason, they have this little bit here where you have to walk through and load up a couple places. Alright, let's go... out. To the entrance of Hamelin. Now we shall sleep because it sounds like we're going to the Miasma Marshes, which sound a little dangerous. So let us sleep. $140 gold. Not bad.